Hey, this is Onne from Lussive Audio. I am super excited to present you my new VST plugin called ClipLAB. Ever since I started using Logic's Clip Distortion a long time ago to create these hardstyle crunchy kick drums, I knew I was on a mission. I wanted to make it available for any DAW for both Windows and Mac, and so I created ClipLAB. But ClipLAB is more than just the traditional asymmetrical clip distortion. There are a lot more features built right in, like preset management, pre-EQ, randomization, and subcontrol, making ClipLAB your clip distortion powerhouse. So let's check it out. Let's listen to what it can do. Let's drag it onto our channel like that. What I've used now as a source is a simple 909 saturated kick drum. So, but you can use any source. So you can use it on a serum, on a sample, on a silent kick drum, kick 3, whatever is your source material, it doesn't matter. ClipLAB will distort it. So if we look at the plugin UI, it's a modern plugin. So it's fully resizable. It's very convenient. It has a utility section where you can load and save presets. It has the pre-EQ built right in, randomize, then the essential drive and asymmetrical clip distortion features, including visual feedback. And we have post effects, like in the same way that the original clip distortion has. It has a high shelf band, which you can increase or decrease, a low-pass filter to tame up the result, chaos mode, a subshaper, which is kind of new, which allows you to resurrect the sub-frequencies or have cool effects with it. And there's, of course, then the input mix and output controls. And there is a toggle that allows you to either clip inside of the plugin, which basically makes this an inflator as well. So you can also forget about that one. You don't need that anymore, technically speaking. But also you can also disable that, which allows you to actually clip on the DAW itself, on the channel, and then use additional plugins to destroy your sound. So let's listen to what it sounds in the init. Let's go to the init like that. There it is. But let me instantly show you what it can do with just this single plugin instance. Let me load the preset Hardstyle Crunch. Let me lower the mix so you don't hear it yet. And let me then open the mix so you can hear what it actually does. Just with one single plugin, you get this crunchy sound already. Even get the attack out right away, right from this single plugin. So, what is worthwhile mentioning? Well, let's start with the init preset, because the input itself and the output already give you quite a nice clipping effect. So let's play around with that. Yes, pretty saturated. And now, as you can see on the FL Studio mixer, it's clipped at 0 dB. And if I change the toggle to off of the clip output, you'll see that it starts clipping on the master. Allowing you to further process the sound. It's up to you. So what is really interesting here is that, let me just play around with a few examples so you can hear what it can do. As you can see, I've labeled these presets with the source material in it, because of course the distortion effect acts different to the source material you put it on, even the key where you put it on, the key of the kick or even the snare, whatever you want to put it on. So I'm gonna just guide you through the ones that are mapped to the 909 saturated, so you can have an idea of what you can create with just one single sample and one single instance of ClipLAB. just to give you an idea, in a minute I will show you some more examples in an Ableton project that I prepared, so you have an idea what it can do on Serum, just an Init Serum, what it can do on the drummer zone, etc., etc. But for now, let's have a look at the features. So like I said, we have the EQ. Let's pick the Hardstyle crunch again, and let's start by completely disabling the EQ. This is what you would normally get with just an distortion plugin. Like that. And what happens when I enable the EQ? I can play around with certain parts of the frequency range, which is normally what we would do in an EQ distort combination. But now it's bundled in one plugin. But obviously, of course, you can also stack ClipLAB to get the EQ distort, EQ distort, EQ distort, but then with just one plugin less. Very convenient, there is a musical note mode, which I can toggle, and then it locates the closest note to the actual frequency that you had it on. And now you can tune your attack sound that you're getting out of the distorted signal in a better way. So let's try it. You hear the difference. So, and that you can do on EQ 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you can do it on the tone of the actual clip distortion algorithm. As you can see, what I did here is on EQ 1, I created some room around the 200-300 Hz. I had a very wide bandwidth, meaning that it's a quite wide bell. The more I put this to the right, the more it starts to peak. Let's listen to that. Like that. And on EQ 3 and 4, the difference is that it doesn't have a peak control, it has a panning control, which allows you to create a really nice stereo effect without actually really interrupting the main signal. So let's check it out. Let's go for EQ 3. Let's put that on, I don't know, 900 Hz. Right. Let's put this one on 1200. Like that, so you get this really more of a stereo effect with the panning of the EQ 3 and 4. But now let's go to the real magic part, which is the drive, tone, clip filter, symmetry, and intensity. These are modeled similarly to the original clip distortion. So the drive, it actually has an extra parameter. You would only have the drive, but I increased it even more with the intensity. So let's play around to see what this does. I'm going to lower the effect of the EQs a bit, like that. This is more drive. Ooh, the tone all the way down is usually pretty nice. It's actually a low cut, a high pass filter. You can tame the filtered effect a bit with the clip filter. Especially useful for when you put it on an actual reverse bass or a bass line, because we don't always have to think of kicks. You can just obviously distort way more. Now let's check out the symmetry. Normally you would distort each part of the waveform, so the top part and the bottom part equally. But with the symmetry effect, you can play around with that by making it negative or positive. This is where the real crackle comes in. The crunch. And now for the post-processing, this is also used quite a lot. It's actually funny, maybe I should show you this from an Init preset, because it already gives you quite a nice result when playing around with just boosting the signal. Let me do that. Let me put this to 20. Around. This is also the part where I would like to show you the actual low cut of the EQ and the slope. This is what most producers that have experience in creating distorted kick drums know, that a low cut gives the kick and the distortion some breathing room, which allows the harmonics, etc., to be distorted and give a specific tone. And that's always good to play around with. And I now mapped a control to it, so it's easy for you to do. And of course, because we impact the low frequencies of the signal, it is most of the times convenient to restore that. You can do that with a separate layer, but I've added a control for it, a sub shaper and the sub gain, which allows you to restore or even use it as a creative effect, the sub part of the kick drum. Even without EQing applied, so let's increase it a bit more by applying some EQ. This is a pretty solid tip. So three more things actually. First of all, the randomize feature. Really nice for creating kick effects or whatever you like. And from there, of course, you can tweak all the controls. Tooltips, well, if you hold down the mouse for a specific amount of time, I think it's 2 seconds, on a control, the help mode is enabled, allowing you to read what all the controls do, which is quite convenient. And then there's chaos mode. Chaos mode is a bit of an experimental thing that I added. It might not be suitable for everyone, but it's especially something that's always what I like to do in my plugins and contact instruments. I like to bring some innovation, something new, something strange, which sort of isn't done in the rest of the plugin development scene. And that's what this chaos filter actually does as well. Because it gives you some sort of comb filtering delay effect on the kick drum. It does in certain settings affect the pitch a bit. Like I said, it brings chaos. Let's check it out. So in the beginning, you can really emphasize it as a attack tuner in a way. And when you put it all the way to the right, it gives you this delay type of effect, a bit of a robotizer. On some sources, it really sounds amazing, and sometimes it's chaos. It's just chaos and it's noise, whatever. But yeah, play around with it, check it out, and yeah, you can save your own presets, share your own presets with others. The plugin is available now at my Lussive Audio Store, and I'm the developer, I'm the designer, I'm the creative lead, I'm the project manager, I'm the web developer. It's basically put, it's a one-man job. Really proud of that, and therefore even more excited to hear what you think of it. So now let me load up the Ableton project so you can hear what ClipLAB can do on different source material. But before I'm going to play the audio, I'm going to show you that the plugin itself is also fully automatable directly in your DAW, so all the controls can be automated like this. Just prepared this so you can see that, which is really convenient. Now let's go to the audio. Let's start with the one that we already know. We're at 155 BPM now. That's cool, that's on a 909 sample. Now this is also on a sample. More aggressive. This is actually on a Drumazon 909 kick drum. A bit more raw. And then this is interesting. I put it on a microtonic bass line, so it's turned off by default. Let's listen to how it sounds. And then let's put on the ClipLAB single plugin. Bit of the old school bass line stuff. Let's increase the tempo a bit to, let's say, 180, so we can make some more noise in a faster tempo. Like that. Ooh, serum. And let's see what this is. There we go. Let's enable it. On a 909 saturated kick drum. So, like I said, the plugin is out now at the Lussive Audio Store. It's available as a VST3 and an audio unit, so for both Windows and Mac, and it has been quite a lot of work, so I hope you will support me on this, especially since it's a one-man job. I'm curious to learn how you will use it in your productions. If you have any feature requests or experience any issues, just let me know. I'm excited about the release of ClipLAB, and I hope you are too, and see you next time.